Julie Pivas. I'm the Health and Wellness Coordinator for Milwaukee High School. We're located in a suburb outside of Portland, Oregon, Milwaukee. We serve 1,200 students at Milwaukee High School. Every year we see about 250 students. Some of the challenges that our students face are stress at home. Some of them are experiencing homelessness. A little more than 50% of our students are food insecure. And so we really work to identify how we can mediate these stressors for our students so they can be successful in academics, athletics, and the arts that they pursue.
First, I'll share a little bit about our mental health task force team. As a program coordinator, I sit on that team with our school counselors, our administration, and then also adult advisors, or our teachers in the school that are committed to students' mental health and their social and emotional development. And we work on offering professional development opportunities to teachers. And then we also invite two youth members to sit on that council so that they can help us promote mental health as a population program. And through that, we developed and identified Sources of Strength, which is a population-based peer-led program for them to talk about 8 areas of strength in their life to promote mental health.
We'll continue the mental health task force into next year. And so it will be a sustained partnership between the health center, the county public health agency with their suicide prevention coordinator, and the school administration and staff to continue trainings for the staff as well as the Sources of Strength activities for both peer and student leaders and adult advisors in that way. The program Sources of Strength, which is a suicide prevention program that highlights 8 areas of strength, will continue into the next 2 school years. As a health and wellness center, it's really important for us to be listening to staff and to students and to our administration. An example of this is that teachers see their students dealing with mental health concerns in very different ways in their classrooms than we see that in the clinic environment. My advice to other school-based health centers that are hoping to promote a mental health program in their school is to reach out to their administration and school staff and really listen to their concerns and dreams for the future for their students, and then from there just coming together and making sure that you have that open way of communication to work together to solidify these programs and helping our students learn. So our wellness team is committed to being integrated within the school and then also being school and youth focused. One way that my position gets to interact with that is facilitating our youth advisory council. And so they give us feedback. We meet with them every week about how we can be better serving our students. And they also take the lead on some of our population health programs. And we've really learned to utilize our youth's voices in reducing the stigma of coming across to the Health and Wellness Center. We are in a separate building by just about 10 or 15 steps, and so using them to really integrate with the school and being accessible to all of our students, and they know where they can receive healthcare during the day.